Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the brand new cryo dismemberment death effect that was added into Call of Duty Modern Warfare. I'm not entirely sure if that would be the official name of it, but we've been seeing some variations on how these weapons can take enemies out, so death effect seems pretty fitting considering we had that back in BO4. So what's the difference between regular dismemberment and cryo dismemberment? Instead of the enemy just exploding and seeing parts of their body fly everywhere, they will now be flash frozen and you'll see them sliding across the map, in some cases super far distances. And when you go to check the body, you'll see parts of their limbs smoking, almost like a dry ice effect. This is applied to the two weapons in the pack. That would be the SCAR and of course the Striker 45. Both of them do the same thing. It doesn't matter. You can shoot off people's legs, arms, and of course their dome. And once you do that, well, they'll be sliding all around the map, so stay frosty. The other thing that this pack comes with is an ice pick melee weapon. Now, unfortunately, and I say unfortunately because I really wish they would have done this, it is only a blueprint for the combat knife. Like, I knew it was going to be a blueprint as soon as I saw it part of a pack, but I was really hoping it would be a Cali stick blueprint. That way we could run around with two of them and dual wield them, and it would be similar to the Modern Warfare 2 mission, and missed opportunity, I gotta say. Missed opportunity. I'm sure the team at Infinity Ward had messed around with that idea, but I would have loved to see that happen. You know, I started to think a little bit about this while I was recording this commentary. I would really love to have this as a double blueprint. And what I mean by that is one for the standard combat knife and one for the Cali stick. So if I wanted to dual wield them, I had the opportunity. If I wanted to only use one of them, I had the opportunity. And it would unlock for both of those melee weapons. We already know that there are twin blades coming in the future, so I would really like to see just one blade as well. This would be really nice, and I guess it could be retroactively added for people who purchased this pack, but man, that would have been a nice little bonus. I don't know if you guys remember, but back during Season 2, when the Talon Operator was added, there was a small misprint in the Activision blog saying that his dog's name was Sasquatch. Now, this never came to be because the dog's name actually turned out to be Indiana. But now with the Wendigo pack, Sasquatch has officially been added to the game. Once again, just being an execution, a finishing move, you can use this to tear out the throats of your enemies over and over and over again. And you get a pretty cool outfit for Kruger too. This is probably one of my favorite designed outfits in Modern Warfare at this point. So why am I making this video? I want to talk about something because a lot of people have been bringing up realism. Realism is something that just doesn't really seem to work in regard to a video game. We have had this happen before with Call of Duty World War II, and I actually brought this up, I think last year. Last year I brought this up, saying that, you know, if they try to stay realistic, at some point it's going to skew and it's not going to be as real as everyone expects it to be. We saw World War II go from something that was very strict camouflage-wise, gameplay-wise, everything, and just kind of blow itself out of the water with tons of customization, tons of different camouflage patterns, and much, much more, which I think infinitely made it a better game. Not from the sake of customization or anything like that, but just from the sake of gameplay perspective, having infinite sprint back and everything just made a huge change. And the customization wasn't bad. Being able to unlock more and, of course, have more to go for, that's always a plus. So what I'm really trying to say is, Infinity Ward, you better start adding some camos that are animated! We would really like animated camouflage patterns, please. That's what I meant to say. What am I really trying to say? I mean, what is realism anyway? What is realism when we're talking about a video game where you can jump from the sky with your anime waifu weapon and blast somebody with tracer rounds? What is realism? It's been thrown out the window for a long time now, and that's not to say it's a bad thing. I think that really Infinity Ward could do anything at this point, and I'm really curious what Treyarch is going to do for their next title. We already know that Warzone is going to be shared between pretty much every other Call of Duty game that comes out. We could see Treyarch infiltrate the Warzone in some way, shape, or form. You know, the Cold War era is being rumored right now. But what does that mean for realism when it comes to the next Call of Duty game? You guys catch my drift? It's not like all of the stuff that Infinity Ward did in Warzone is gonna go away. The only way that they could set the tone in their next Call of Duty game without Warzone kind of infecting that era would be to simply separate the two. Like maybe a new selection menu comes up, you go to Warzone, and instead of just being thrown into the playlist menu, you get to choose whether you want to play Modern Warfare Warzone or Treyarch Warzone, whether that's Cold War or Black Ops or whatever that you're going to call it. I don't know. Instead of it being a completely cohesive environment where everything is mixed together, it's going to be two separate experiences on two separate maps. We just don't know at this point, but the vibe that we've been getting is that it's all going to be one cohesive experience. And if that's the case, are we going to have our anime waifu weapons with our, you know, Frank Woods Cold War era weapons coming together in this huge amalgamation of fun? I'm really hoping so. I like the idea of that, but does that mean it throws the realism and, of course, the era and the feeling out the window when it comes to what Treyarch's trying to create with their own era and the creative liberties that they've taken with their new game? I have no idea how the hell this works. I'm confused. I'm just as confused as everybody else. There was one point in my life where I thought, you know what, I really don't want them to besmirch World War II. I don't want them to besmirch the past. I want it to stay realistic and keep it cohesive, and I want it to all stay real. But now I'm at the point where it's like, we're talking about a video game. Maybe I want to see them big flopping honkers on the weapon as a charm. Maybe I want to see this dude get shot in his ass, and then you see rainbows fly out the top of his head, or, you know, magma explodes from his balls or some shit. I mean, this is the type of stuff that I would really like to see. It's almost vitriolic in nature just because I know it's gonna piss people off, and that's why I love using things like that. But anyway, it's a really confusing time, as you can see. We don't really know what the heck is going to happen with Treyarch's next title. We have no idea what's going to be happening with our next update in Modern Warfare, and who knows what type of wacky things will be making their way into the multiplayer. I surely don't know. But I'd like to see, you know, some stuff come in the future in regard to camouflage patterns. I know that we've been getting some, you know, code packs, the Call of Duty Endowment packs, which includes a camo pattern. We got the CWL packs that include a camo pattern, but I want to see some unique ones. Like, I'd like to see a Spectrum V2 that I can apply to everything, or Spectrum V3 at this point. I'd like to see them break away from blueprints containing only that particular feature. Give us a customization option where we can add tracer rounds to any of the weapons in the game, no matter the color, if we've unlocked it in the shop. Give us the ability to add dismemberment and cryo dismemberment to any weapon we want. Admittedly, a lot of people don't like using the Striker 45 or the SCAR. I'm one of those people. But because the dismemberment is pretty cool, I guess I can hang with it just for a little bit. The one thing I'm actually confused about, and I really hope that they can actually prove me wrong here, I am hoping, since Warzone is supposed to be connected in some way, shape, or form, that all of the stuff that we're buying in this particular game, blueprint-wise and outfit-wise, can be carried over in some capacity to the next Call of Duty title. Whether that's just in Warzone, I understand, but being able to carry something over that you purchased from a previous game would actually make so much sense, and it would actually add so much value to the item because you get to use it year after year. I guess you could argue that you could go back to BO3, or you could go back to BO4, and you could use those items that you picked up, but it doesn't matter in the now. It doesn't matter in what we're playing today. So who knows if they're going to announce that ever, or maybe they won't. But anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about in this video here today. If you guys enjoyed the conversation and, of course, the gameplay, do me a favor, drop a like on the video, subscribe for more videos coming very, very soon, and if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Catch y'all in the next one. Peace!